actually my decision is I'm Joey from the Suzhou East Taipei office. Here they have one short UI that you guys can use your notebook. Places this UI that you can adapt my slides. Because my slides there are some pictures, the quality is not a little bit, so maybe the projector cannot show up. So my name is Jerry, and my responsibility is to contribute to the open source kernel, and I'm working on the ACPI and BBFI, and sometimes I contribute to hearing, and now also some work on the VTP. So almost my work is in the kernel. So my topic is about the signature replication. So this presentation has two parts. One is it's about the signature replication of the kernel module. Another one is about the case queue, because sometimes we need to take down, the memory content and use a crash to analyze those content to find out what happened in the kernel, especially when the bug happened. So here is the agenda. How to enable the kernel module signature check. Then how to sign your kernel module. Then I will introduce the mechanism of verification. The second part is about the phase queue. The procedure is almost the same. I will introduce how to enable it. Then how to use the PE sign to sign the kernel binary. And the binary is a mechanism for the KSQ file. It's a new system call to provide a kernel binary verification. Okay, the first part is the kernel module side. This mechanism is contributed by David Powers since the 3.7 asking one level on kernel option. David Powers is a subsystem maintainer of the Kirin subsystem. So the original contribution, he chose the crypto algorithm is RSA, and the key identify type is X59. So this function is for if we very care about the kernel module, we need to check the integrity of the kernel module and make sure nobody knows able to change the kernel module. Then know the kernel module kernel that causes our Linux kernel being hacked. Then maybe they can want to some bad hole in the red zero by kernel. So how we enable this function? We can, when you build the kernel, then you can enable standard config module signature. It is the configure to yes. Then another important configure is the module sign or. When you enable this configure, then the kernel field will assign all kernel module when you make it install. Then the data tree is you can choose what the crypto algorithm, the hash algorithm, which algorithm you want. Maybe SHA-1 or SHA-512. Okay, then next, this configure is also important. Is you can set what which key you want to use to sign the kernel module. So you can set this configure and tell the kernel build mechanism to find out the key value. Okay, so by the default, you did not set, did not tell the kernel which key value you want to use, then it will auto-generate one key pair to you. Basically, if you just want to try it, then you can use this auto-generate key. The default, it will generate the key to the CERTS order, then there you will find the two files. First file is including the private key. So the name is the CERT signing key BN. This file you need to be very careful to protect it because it including the private key. If you leak the private key, that means anyone can use the private key to sign their own chromatic. So it's you should avoid this problem. Another one is the certificate. The certificate formatted is S59. It's only have a public key. You can share this file to the other people if they want to verify your kernel. And this kernel will include this file, this certificate to the kernel binary. Because the kernel needs to verify the kernel module by using this certificate when you are loading a kernel module. Okay, sorry for the word is a bit small. Maybe much later. So when you are building the kernel, then you will find the kernel for the local generate the S59 key pair for the kernel module sign, and also it will embed the public key to the kernel binary. And so like this, this is an example. It will build out 4096 bits RSA private key for signing. Of course, later I will introduce one file. You can just modify the file, and it will generate another different type of keys for using. So it will, the kernel will write in a new private key to this file. Okay, then let's see. You can use this OpenSSL log to show up the key pair. You can show the private key. Here is the modules. Modules number. This number will be equal to the modules with the private key. So that's why they can be paired. Okay. This one is to show the certificate with the private key. So you can see the, you can use open SSL X59 to show the info type of the PEM, then show the PEM file, or you can use the VR to show the S59 file, then it will show like this. Then here is the public key, so you can see it show the public key and the key long. And the command name is a few times auto-generated kernel key. So what's the libraries? Okay, yes. So this primary key, this certificate will be embedded to the kernel. So they have one structure, the name, one key ring, the name is system key ring. Kernel will build in this certificate trunk to the key ring, then in the later kernel will verify it. You use it to verify the kernel module. Okay, we just say if you don't like the auto-generated key, maybe you want to modify some configuration to generate a new key, then you can modify this file. This file is the CERTSX 59 gen key, this file. At the beginning, this file did not generate. So after you run the Kernel build, then it will auto generate the one, then we can modify it, then generate the new key. So like here you can, if you looking at this, just using VI to modify the file, you can show the, okay, now the organization, the common name, and like an email, you can use your own email, then the sharp is in the mark up. So you can remove the mark, then it will generate to the first certificate. And like this, the default piece is also important. The default piece known is 4096, so you can change to other own. Okay, that is fine. Okay, you can change the bits to the 2048 on, and you can change the all organization to the open source text maybe. It's depending on what name you want. And then CL is a common name, you also can change it. Then you can use your own email address to generate the key pair. Okay, then after we got the key pair, then we view all the kernel binary, and the kernel binary embedded the public key, the certificate. Then next step, we can use the private key to sign our kernel module. So a simple way is if you want to just want to sign one kernel module, then use this tool. In here, we have one script. The name is a sign file in the kernel source. Then you can use the sign file to sign your kernel module. In this case, we use a SHA-1 to sign our kernel module. This is one example. I signed this SWI KO file, and it will generate one file. The name is SWI sign KO file. And more easily, you can use kernel config. The name is module sign all, which I just used. And it will auto sign all modules by make module install. Okay, here we have configuration option we need to. Maybe you need to know the, if we enable the module sign false to be yes, then that means kernel will force to check the signature of the kernel module. If the kernel module check failed, it will direct reject by showing the required key not available. Required key not available. Then if you do not set this configuration, this option, then the verification failed. It is just a tired kernel by E flag. Then the tired means this kernel got to be tired. Then when the kernel crash, the kernel will show one tired flag. Not one, actually it's a 1-0 tiling frame. Then if we check the tiling frame, it shows E means that someone bought a kernel module that it did not pass the kernel verification, a kernel module verification. Okay, here is one signature of a module. After we sign that, we just say, we can use this way to sign our kernel binary. Then after that, you can use a text dump to show the signature of one kernel module. So there will have buffer string. It's just the end of the kernel module. Then from the this Marcus string interface, actually like this. The Marcus string is in the end of the current module, then it can cut the whole signature. Okay, like this. In kernel source, the structure of the signature, module signature, like this. And I think it's more easy to show, like this one picture to show the structure. And in the end of the signature, they will have one marker length, a marker string, just shown here. Like a module signature append. It's a one string. Then a kernel will find this string and then pass the signature trunk. Okay. So back to this. So the kernel will try to find this string. Then it start to pass the signature structure. It's 12 bytes. Then after the structure, it brought the button to up. And then it can find the signature and the key ID, signer, and the module. The other is the module data. But this format is before the 3.18 version, kernel version. After that, David Powers changed the format. After the 3.18, the format changed to the PKCS7 type. We can show here PKCS7 type. It looks easier. Kernel still try to find the marker string, then pass the module structure, module signature structure. And there will be some information about the type and the signature length. Then the upper is the PKCS status signature. So if you are interested, you can try to find the PKCS7 spec. Then they will have the spec to describe the signature format. And of course, the upper is the module data. Okay, here is one picture about the mechanism of the signature chip in kernel. Okay. When the kernel load one module, then it there will have one call the module.d. It will allow the module, then it will call the module signing is this C file. This module, this object, this object will call the certificate subsystem. So then here is the certificate subsystem. So this function is called by the kernel module subsystem and the certificate subsystem. So the certificate, I just mentioned they have one system key in the kernel, is in the certificate subsystem. Then it will do the something like passing the PKCS signature and also the verify the signature, yeah, almost like a validated it. So for the world main is more. So the first part is pass the message, the signature, PKCS7 message. And the second part is verify it, and the final part is validate the trust. Okay. Then this part is developed by Gary Lin, is in this room, he's there now. They have the one mechanism means the name is MOK. The name, the real name is the full name is machine owner key. Why we need this mechanism is because sometimes the community or any other third party guys want to sign their own the kernel module, sign their own driver. And but we all know the UEFI security group, the certificate is controlled by it will put it in the DB in the UEFI bus firmware. But it's only the manufacturers can do that. For the normal user, for other guys want to use that, then our solution provide a MOK mechanism to them. Then they can import those their own certificate to boost service variable. Then it still can protect by UEFI certificate. So it's very easy because of Gary Wall, tool is a MOK key, and you can just use the MOK key and import this function to import your own certificate to MOK. And after you import, then you put your machine, then you will see this UI show up on the open source. It's also supported by open source, right? Yes, so this UI will show up on your monitor, then you can just follow the GUI to enroll your MOK certificate. And it will ask you if you want to enroll this key. Why we need to leave this interactive with the user? Because the hacker maybe put one bad key. They want to put a better key to do a MOK. Then without this interactive, then maybe anyone can do it. So if you found this UI show up, but you did not do anything, you did not put any key to did not draw the MOK key to put your key, then you should await maybe someone take your machine. Then after that, the position code, you can see the key will be loaded by the DB's kernel. Then you can draw the load certificate if you can't auto chain key. Okay, then second part is a case view. It's another type of a similar mechanism is for because I'm not sure anyone used KDAM before. So if KDAM means you can load one page kernel to a memory. Then after the when the kernel boots or page, it will jump to the entry point of the page kernel and start from the page kernel. Then the page kernel only do one thing is dump whole memory content to one file. For a file, then later you can use a crash tool to analyze the file to find out what happens in the kernel process and system crash. Maybe sometimes a driver or other subsystem cause a problem. But here one security concern is case. You can image anyone can if he got a root to come on, use another way to load the kernel, then he can load anything to your memory. Then when the kernel and he trigger the primary kernel, the booting kernel to boost, then it can jump to the core what you want to want. Maybe not the real kernel, maybe any bad call that you want. We want to take your computer. So that's why we want to verify the binary level. Consumed by the case view. Okay, this function is contributed by the VBAC since 3.7RC1 kernel. Currently, it's only for the SAD 64 architecture, and it depends on the PKCA status in the church act, and the new system called the name is the KSQ firewall. And now the third is the KSQ, the loader is called into the PE5 pass. This is, look at it. Okay, if you want to enable this function, then you need to enable this configuration, those configurations. The first one is the KSQ5. That means a new system call to load the file-based kernel. And the second one is verify. KSQ verify connection. It can use it to verify the kernel binary when the user space application use the KSQ firewall system call to load the file binary. Then it can feed the connection can be checked. It's similar to the kernel module, but just the format will be different. And the third one is kernel SQ, the BZ image verify signature. This is for the, if we want to verify the BZ image, actually you have no choice, apparently the only one. So you should enable it. Okay, then before that, you should know the, this signature check mechanism is only for the PE call in format. So we need to enable the EFI stuff, and it can be it will generate the EFI stuff in the kernel binary. Then the kernel can be executed as one EFI executable by the shield. So that means they will have a PE call handle in the kernel binary. So this kernel can be directly executed by UEFI shield. So this is one new boot protocol in the kernel. The name is a 2.11. Now the GUAP2, the open source GUAP2 or slave GUAP is supporting the protocol to call the EFI star. So when you want to use a KDOT, you can enable the KDOT service. Okay, like this. And just use the system control status KDOT-L, and it will show the KDOT status. Now you can see this fail. But why it fail? Because the signature check failed. Because we did not sign the kernel binary. So it's a key feature by service. That means maybe you sign the kernel with the key that is not cannot be recognized by kernel, or it's not in the MOK, not in EB, or you even did not sign your kernel binary. So that's why the KSQ file system code reject. Okay. So of course this function should be enabled by the kernel option. After that, you need to rebuild your kernel. So how to sign your BZ image, the mean the kernel image. It's an easy way you can enable the module sign, kernel module sign, as we mentioned in the first part, that it will generate the key pair. Then you can enroll the certificate to the MOK. Then you may need to use a Mozilla NSS tool to sign the and the PE sign to sign your kernel. Then after you prepare those things, then you can start to sign kernel. Here have one simple procedure to sign. You should create your own certificate database in your local machine. Then here the procedure just run the certificate to enroll the certificate to the database. Then later So I will introduce one screen to you guys and very easy to reproduce, reproduce this procedure. Then it will generate one database, detail database to follow the sign. Then later, it's a P sign. P sign can be used to sign all the module. Actually, P sign can be used to sign the P call format files, not just a module. So it can use the P sign and you call the OpenSSL to sign in. If you can use an OpenSSL to generate some signature structure attributes files, then use those attribute files to sign in by P sign. Here I have one script I wrote and put on the GitHub, and you can download it and just check the script. It's not very easy script, but you can check the procedure. Now, you use the script, just the two steps. One is the initial database, and the other one is find the your kernel binary. Okay, then here is one example to use a KSQ to system call to load. KSQ util to load the one side kernel. Okay, so it's just for you can test your signed kernel. And after that, you can copy signed kernel to the boot folder to request your original kernel, then reboot the system, and then check the KDOM status. It should show the success.
File. This is a C file.
And in the which is one season called the KSQ5 node, then it will call the call is in the architecture x86 kernel. So now I just mentioned this function only for the x86 64 architecture. Then it call the certificate of transit. Call the crypto first. Call the crypto keys. This system. And here we have one verified P5 signature code. And here we have some function with a verified PE signature, PE5 passing, PE5 stream, and digital PE. Those are functions to passing the PE header and get the signature, then go to check, verify the, then to call the certificate, then call the certificate subsystem to check the KCS7 signature like we just do in the kernel module side. There's a whole structure like this. you can use this tunnel option to point to your keypad. Then it will generate to it will extract the public key and build it into the cable. Is it is your question? Okay. Then if you don't want to use a file, then you can and use a URI. So, but the URI need to follow PKCSD format. Then the kernel can be parsing it. Then it will strip the public key, then embed it to a kernel, then use the public key to check the kernel module or check the kernel binary that will be endorsed by the KSQ. So you sure. Because SUSE today for the enterprise. Yeah, just an open source design enabled function. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your attention.